In Kubernetes, every container needs its fair share of CPU resources in order to function. We need to make sure that they get enough, but not more than their fair share. That is where requests and limits come into play. And to help picture this, here's a big old pile of CPU sandwiches. That's a whole pile of sandwiches, but let's say that three of them have our pod's container's name written on them. This means our pod is guaranteed these three sandwiches. It will always have this much to eat. But here's the thing, there's a lot of sandwiches here. What's stopping your container from just pigging out and eating more than its fair share? Nothing. And that's why we have limits. Limits describe the maximum of that resource that your pod's container is able to use. So if our pod tries to consume more than the limit, Kubernetes will throttle the pod, forcing it to slow down. So let's try this in an actual manifest. And in this pod, you can see we have a busybox container. It has no limits, no requests. Without those, one of two possibilities could happen. Starvation. Your little pod is thrown into the cold, cold cluster without even a crumb to support itself and it starves. Or overindulgence. It might just devour all the cluster resources, not leaving anything for other pod containers. So that is why we are adding this section right here. Now, the way that Kubernetes measures CPU is through millicore. 1,000 millicore equals one virtual CPU. And what we're doing here is we're guaranteeing that this container has at least 250 millicore, or 0.25 virtual CPU, but it may not consume more than 500 millicore, or half of a vCPU. And remember, if it tries to go above that limit, it's going to get throttled! So let's make this pod inside of a real Kubernetes cluster, and we can check if these requests and limits are in place by just describing the pod after it's been created. And once we look up through that output, we can see that our requests and limit are exactly as we said in our manifest. Now, checking on whether or not your pods are actually approaching those limits, or even if they're using all of the resources allocated to them through requests, can be done through all sorts of monitoring tools, but if you use kubectl top, we can see we're using a bare 3 millicore of CPU for this very simple container. Just goes to show, even if you guarantee through a request a lot of resources, it doesn't necessarily mean that the container is going to use all of them. So to help you configure requests and limits the right way, here are some best practices for you to keep in mind. Start small, then adjust. Don't just guess. Start with a low request and work your way up, kind of sneaking up on it. Low limits are bad because if your pod exceeds those limits, then it's going to be throttled and your application is going to suffer. High requests are also bad because those are wasted resources. Even if they are not being used, they still cannot be touched. They belong to that container, so don't be writing blank checks for your containers. And I would also recommend that you take a look into resource quotas and limit ranges. These are administrator tools that can be applied to Kubernetes namespaces and are a big, big part of the whole resource management features of Kubernetes. If you'd like to learn more about those, then we can make a future video on that. This video helped. Let us know down inside of the comments what other Kubernetes topics you'd like to know more about. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.